welcome to High School Hockey 97, and welcome to South Windsor Arena, home of the defending state champion South Windsor Bobcats in Division II. Last year, they were the state champs, and tonight, in a big contest, they'll be hosting the Manchester Indians. Good game on tap for tonight. Peter Talbot, along with the Cox Television crew, our director tonight, Donna Fontano, our technical director, Peter Cakley, on audio tonight, Pete Chomak, instant replay, Sean Ratchis, and our camera operators, James Perkins, Kevin DeMello, and Bob Plunkett. Both teams getting set for the opening faceoff in this contest in what promises to be a great game. Of course, the South Windsor Bobcats moving up to Division I this year following their state championship run last season. Manchester goalie Kevin Liske, the senior, will open in the nets for the Manchester Indians tonight. He goes over to huddle around his team and their head coach, Paul Lombardo. Final preparations being made. There is the South Windsor bench, huddled around Coach Dave Fisher. Should be a very entertaining hockey game tonight at South Windsor Arena. Both these squads have some very talented young players.
Now let's play hockey!
Referee signaling both goaltenders. And we're set for the drop of the puck. McKenney, Peck, and Latanzio open up across the front line for Manchester. On defense, Major and Blomstrom. The goalie is Liske. Down into the South Windsor end, they open up with Swerbatowicz. Short and Hayden across the front line. Symes and Papagionis on defense. And Ray Hall is their goaltender. There is Ray, number one in the nets for the Bobcats tonight. Face-off just to the left-hand side of Hall. Controlled by South Windsor. Up the near boards. Swerbatowicz carries in for South Windsor. Taken now by Short. Back to the point. The shot from the point is blocked by the Manchester defense. And back the other way comes the Manchester Indians. In the zone, a shot that's gloved by Hall. At center ice, South Windsor dumps in and they will change. Opening moments of play here at South Windsor Arena between South Windsor and Glastonbury. Manchester dumps it in and will be called for the offside. Faceoff will come outside the zone. Adam Major, the all-state senior defenseman for Coach Paul Lombardo, gets his opening break. Faceoff will come to the right of Liske. Controlled by the Indians. Manchester tries to dig it out. Kept in a wraparound try for South Windsor by Hantos. Blocked nicely by Hall, by Liske, I'm sorry. Back into the South Windsor end. Manchester touches to avoid the icing call. Shot, a kick save, the follow, and another great save by Ray Hall. A couple tries there for Manchester. And Hall up to the task as he stops both of them. Backhander and then a rebound try. Faceoff will come to the right-hand side of Ray Hall. McKenney takes the faceoff and controls for Manchester. South Windsor moves the puck out over the left-hand side. Manchester defense stops him up. And back the other way comes the Manchester Indians. Joe Peck with the puck. Throws it on goal. And a tipping shot, a rebound. And that's the first goal of the game. And that should go to Latanzio. Tom Latanzio with the rebound shot as the junior, number 14, puts one in off the rebound shot. Kenny will get the assist. That goal coming at the 1:57 mark of the first period. And here's the replay. Dumped in there by McKenney, and then the follow by Latanzio. Actually, Joe Peck, number 7, took the initial shot.
Number 14, Tom Latanzio, assisted by number 6, Mike McKenney. Time to go at 1:57.
Also crediting McKenney, but I think Peck probably deserves an assist as he took that opening shot that was initially blocked away by Hall, but Latanzio's follow is good for the 1-0 Manchester lead. Less than 2 minutes into the contest, and Manchester on the board. South Windsor applying the pressure back the other way. Deep in the zone, the shot goes wide. Corralled again by Short. Short keeps it in. Drops it behind the net, feeds it out front. Goes all the way back to the blue line. Short gets it in the middle, tries to keep it in. That's taken away by Griffin Doyle. Manchester dumps down. Gagne giving chase. South Windsor comes back the other way. A big shot deflected out of bounds by Swerbatowicz. Big number 17, Adam Swerbatowicz, had that shot deflected up over the glass. Faceoff will be in the Manchester zone. 11:53 to go, first period. Peter Talbot along with the Cox Television crew. Manchester on top, 1-0 on Latanzio's goal. Manchester controls. Kept in at the point by Ledestri. Now South Windsor is able to bat it out. Nice hip check there for South Windsor. Manchester controls and on the rush. It's McKenney. He already has one goal and he shoots wide. McKenney, the assister, tried to turn goal scorer there. Just shooting it wide. The Bobcats in the near zone, can't control. Manchester moves it ahead. Easy save for Ray Hall. Dumps it off for Lapira, number 11. South Windsor controls again. Antos, number 2, up the near boards. Manchester throws it back into the South Windsor zone. And they'll be called for the offside call. Here a look at South Windsor head coach Dave Fisher. State title in his belt. Last year, the Division II state champions. Ryan Short will take the faceoff for South Windsor against Griffin Doyle for Manchester. Controlled by the Bobcats. Manchester puts the pressure on. Mike Fleming, number 10, applying the pressure. And that one is tipped out. We've got a whistle. Look at the Manchester bench on the far side. Face-off just outside the blue line. Controlled by the Bobcats. Up the left side they come. 2-on-1 break. Big slap shot. Blocked away by Eliski. Shot was by Ryan Short, and it was a good one from just inside the blue line. Behind the goal, kept in. Swerbatowicz feeds across. South Windsor still keeps in as Short feeds it down behind the glass. Swerbatowicz checked away from the puck by Major. Shot again by Short. That one wide. And the puck comes outside the zone, and South Windsor will set it up again. On the rush, number 14 brings it in for Manchester, Latenzio. That'll be called for an offside. The shot will not count. Latanzio's goal is the difference thus far. 1-0 Manchester lead. Assisted by Kenny officially. We're also throwing Peck in there for an assist. Pantos carries in for South Windsor. Lapira tries to keep it alive, and covering up for Manchester is Liske. Faceoff will come inside the zone. Shot taken by number 21, Hayward. Antos will take the faceoff for South Windsor. Squares off against McKenney. Controlled by the Indians. South Windsor brings it back the other way. Taken away by Peck, number 7. Hayward drops it back to the Manchester blue line. Nice poke check. Bobcats number 11, Lapira. Now across the blue line. Rister blocked away on the defense by Nick Roy, number 4. Behind the Manchester goal. Taking a chop at it again. It's tucked out. McKenney corrals and gets it outside the zone for Manchester. Sends it all the way down the boards. Ball will touch it up as South Windsor regroups and starts up ice. Sent back down into the South Windsor zone. Up along the right side to Lapira. Kept in nicely by Major. Major shot is no good. And South Windsor able to clear. And a Major. The All-Stater goes back for it. Sends it up to Gagne along the left wing, and it's an offside pass. And the faceoff will come outside the South Windsor blue line. They'll bring this one all the way back into Manchester ice as we get a nice look at Eric Gagne, the sophomore forward for Coach Paul Lombardo. Michael Griffin Doyle, junior defenseman, will take the faceoff against Ryan Short, controlled by South Windsor, although it ends up in a break for Manchester. Nice slap shot by Mike Fleming is blocked away by Hall. And we've got our first infraction of the contest. This one's going to be going against South Windsor, and they're shaken up on the play. Here's Eric Gagne stretching it out, but the penalty will go against South Windsor. And Chris L. Jenkins will get the gate. Be a power play for the Bobcats. Penalty coming at the 7:10 mark of the first period. Griffin Doyle will take the faceoff against Swobodowicz. Tied up in the skates and taken away by South Windsor. Ryan Short. And there was the penalty against Chris L. Jenkins. Not only with the 2 minutes for checking, but also a 10-minute misconduct. So he will not see action until the second period of tonight's game. Manchester on the power play. South Windsor doing a nice job on the kill. South Windsor controlling the puck and again firing deep down into the Manchester end. Just over 7 minutes remaining first period. Indians' first power play. Play at center ice again, fired in by South Windsor. They're doing a great job of killing the penalty. They've killed half of it already. Manchester finally corrals, and carrying in is Major. Major dumps it to the right side, but South Windsor takes it back immediately and is able to clear the zone. South Windsor feeds it back into their own end and clears all the way down. Touching up is Liske as they start it back again on the Manchester Indian power play, wrapping it around the boards one more time, setting up from behind. Deflected away by South Windsor, but Manchester controls. At center ice, McKenney stick handles and fires one on net. Sticked away by Hall. Back into the corner as Manchester controls. This their best look on the power play tonight. Nice effort by Latanzio to keep it in. And now South Windsor just able to clear. Penalty is over. South Windsor doing a nice job of the kill. A nice shot on goal on the short side for South Windsor that was sticked away by Liske. And we've got an icing call against the Manchester Indians. Faceoff will come down in front of Liske, the senior goaltender for Manchester. 1-0 our score here at the South Windsor Arena. Peter Talbot along with the Cox Television crew. The goal by Latanzio at the 1:57 mark. Look at the Indian now to a 1-0 lead. Our director tonight is Donna Fontano. Peter Kickley, our technical director. Peter Chomak on audio. Sean Ratchis on the replay tonight. James Perkins, Kevin DeMello, and Bob Plunkett, our camera operators. South Windsor keeps in at the far boards. Chris M. Jenkins keeps it in. Now Manchester able to tip it out. Jason Symes corrals and sends ahead for South Windsor. Center of the ice is Jenkins. Feeds it in. Taken away by Manchester and they'll feed it down. South Windsor back the other way. Hayward with the puck. The glove of Jenkins lays on the ice there to the right-hand side of Liske. Bissonnette tries to tap it out, but kept in by the Bobcats as they apply the pressure. That comes short. Carries in, feeds it off. Short gets it in, flips it near side wide. Greg Gway, number three, keeps it in. Nice effort is South Windsor with a lot of nice pressure here. Big slapper from the center of the ice is kicked away. Is number 14 for South Windsor. Pat Hayden let that one rip. Nice chance there for the Bobcats once again as Manchester will ice the puck to give themselves a break. Great pressure by South Windsor as they turn it up here in the closing minutes of the first period, trailing 1-0 in the contest. Running short was the Bobcat. He will square off against Griffin Doyle. Manchester forces it ahead. South Windsor goes deep to Corral. Back of their own blue line. Now sending it into the zone, firing it up near boards. And we've got a whistle for two-line pass. That'll come back down into the Bobcat zone. Bobcats wearing the home white, and of course the Manchester Indians in the red with white trim uniforms tonight. Griffin Doyle will again take the face-off for the Indians. Scoring off against Hantos. Scoring off against Hayward, that is. Or Short, I'm sorry, number 12, Ryan Short. So they'll redrop. And it'll be Ryan Short for South Windsor and Griffin Doyle again for Manchester. This one controlled by the Bobcats, but stolen away in front. Nice opportunity for Gagne is stick checked off the puck. He would have had a chance dead on right in front of Hall. South Windsor able to clear. A little bit deep on the pass for Swerbatowicz. He goes in deep into the right-hand corner to Corral. Feeds it out in front. It is sticked away. And we've got another whistle and a penalty upcoming. This one to the Manchester Indians. I believe Gagne is going to get the gate this time. Number 18, Eric Gagne, will get the two-minute call. Penalty comes at the 11:53 mark, and the referee signals it's for elbowing. Just over 3 minutes to go. Manchester is able to send it down ice as they attempt to kill their first penalty of the game. And indeed, Gagne for elbowing at 11:53. This is a South Windsor Bobcat power play. This is their first power play of the contest. Swerbatowicz tries to poke it away, poke it ahead. Knocked down by Manchester, and again, they will send it down, keeping South Windsor out of the zone. Carried in this time by Papagiannis. Shot covered up by Ilyski. Again, a nice job to cover up right in front. Pressure applied by Pat Hayden. And the senior goaltender for Manchester is able to cover up. Faceoff will still be in the Manchester zone. Manchester holds on to that 1-0 lead. But the Bobcats are on the power play. Hantos, number two, wins the draw. Shot from the point is deflected up and over the glass. And we'll have another face-off. Tom Collins, number 15, for South Windsor. Right at the blue line. Hantos takes the draw. Won by Manchester, and they send it all the way down into the South Windsor zone. Nice job of penalty killing tonight by both squads. Over the left board, sticked away, and Manchester is able to clear it down. Back to Corral is Symes. Manchester again just dumps it into the South Windsor zone. Good job of killing off the penalty. Being served by Eric Gagne, 2 minutes for elbowing. Wrapping it around is Major, the big defenseman, on the penalty unit. Shot just wide of Liske. Manchester cannot clear. Gets control and sends it out. And that should just about do it for the South Windsor power play. Near side comes to Lapera, number 11. He has trouble with it. Kenny has it, feeds it over for Gagne. Shoots across the open face of the net. South Windsor has the puck, and we may have another penalty upcoming here. Looks like South Windsor will get a two-minute minor. Indeed, going into the box, number two is Bill Hantos, and he'll serve 2 minutes for interference. That at the 14-12 mark, so for another 58 seconds to close out the 48 seconds to close out this period, another minute 12 to open up the second period.
2 minutes for interference. Time of the penalty at 14-12.
And there was the call by the PA announcer as Hantos, 2 minutes for interference at 14-12. So Manchester, 30 seconds remaining now in their man advantage. They'll open up the second period with a man advantage as well. Having trouble with the puck is Liske, and that was very dangerous. South Windsor could have come up with a shorthanded goal at that point. Manchester corrals. They feed it up the boards, up the right side, taken away by South Windsor. Two-on-one break. Feeding it over to the side. And that will do it for the first period of action. So we've wrapped up the first period here at South Windsor Arena. Peter Talbot along with our Cox Television crew and Manchester enjoying a 1-0 advantage at the end of one period. Number 17, joins his teammates, Coach Dave Fisher. And let's recap the scoring and the penalties for you. Latanzio got the goal at the 1:57 mark for Manchester. McKenney and Peck on the assists. Penalties in the period. A pair for South Windsor, Chris L. Jenkins. 2 minutes for checking and a 10-minute misconduct. We'll be back for the second period in just a moment.
With pay-per-view, the hits come right into your home, hassle-free, instantly. It's the easy way to treat friends and family to first-run fun. And everyone watches for one low price, making pay-per-view one of the best entertainment values around. Just pick the showing you want to see and follow the simple pay-per-view ordering instructions. Before you know it, you'll be enjoying the movie of your choice right in your home. Big hits, small price. There's nothing to it when you pay-per-view it.
Bring home hot Hollywood hits with Cox Cable.
Back here at South Windsor Arena, Peter Talbot along with the Cox Television crew as we get ready for the second period of action between the Manchester Indians and the South Windsor Bobcats. Our director for tonight's game, Donna Fontana. Peter Cakley as we face off to open up the second period. Peter Cakley, our TV, audio, Peter Chomak, replay, Sean Ratchis, and camera operators, James Perkins, Kevin DeMello, and Bob Plunkett. South Windsor sends it down into the Manchester zone. The Bobcats operating from right to left for this period. Manchester on top by a 1-0 count. Tom Latanzio's goal is the difference thus far in the contest. And a major carries in for Manchester and fires wide of Ray Halley. Knocked out by Pat Hayden down deep into the Manchester end. Manchester on the power play. The carryover of the Bill Hantos penalty. 2 minutes for interference in the first period at the 14-12 mark. So Hantos still off. So Lapira down the right side has it taken away. Griffin Doyle starts up with it for Manchester. Sends it deep into the South Winds arena. And that will be called for an offside. So the faceoff will be outside the blue line of South Windsor. There is Bill Hantos waiting to come back on the ice. The penalty just about over his 2-minute gate for interference in the first period of 14-12 mark, as I mentioned. Peck to take the faceoff. It's won by Peck. Back down deep the other way. As the goal by Brian Lapira, as it looked like Liske had it stopped, but Lapira is able to poke it in again. So Brian Lapira, number 11, comes up with the South Windsor game-tying goal at the 1-minute 12 mark of the second period. An unassisted score for Lapira. There's the replay. It looked like Liske had it stopped, but Lapira, with that extra poke check, just tipped it into the back of the net.
Lapira!
So again, it's Lapira, as you heard, PA announcer here at South Windsor Arena, telling you that Brian Lapira, with the unassisted goal at 1-12, has tied the score at one apiece. Pushing it center ice, and South Windsor again puts the pressure on. They had some great opportunities in the first period, and they capitalize early here in the second to tie things up at one. Bill Hantos back on the ice, turns with it, has it taken away. Back the other way comes Morano. Manchester changes up as number 19 defenseman Adam Major goes back for it. Flips it near boards and out of the zone. South Windsor carries back in. Shot across by Derek Sendrak. Sendrak again has it on the backhand, turns and fires, and a whistle to stop play as the net came off the moorings. Right behind Jason Liske, he'll put things back on with some help from the officials tonight. And the faceoff will come to the right-hand side of Jason Liske, senior goaltender. For head coach Paul Lombardo, Ryan Short will take the faceoff, number 12 for South Windsor. And he'll face off against Michael Griffin Doyle, the junior defenseman. Doyle wins it back to his own zone. It's taken away, though, by Ryan Short. Short to Swerbatowicz, feeds the middle, and it goes all the way back out. Sent back in by Papagiannis. There's an offside, waved off by the officials. South Windsor carries back in. Swerbatowicz feeds it forward. Sends it off for Hayden. Swerbatowicz back to the center. Nice shot by Short. That is kicked away by Jason Liske. And he's able to control the puck for a faceoff. It'll come to his right. Nice job tonight by senior goaltender for Manchester, Jason Liske, as well as South Windsor's netminder, Ray Holly, is doing a nice job tonight in the nets. A pair of number ones squaring off. They've each given up a goal. In the first period, it was Latanzio for Manchester. And here to open up the second period, Lapira for South Windsor. We're all tied up at one. Joe Peck, the captain, senior forward for Manchester, struggles along the boards. It's taken away. Nice shot on net there. Comes from Guay. Greg Guay, number three, with the wrister. Back with an opportunity. One man back. He crosses into South Windsor territory, and he's taken down. Tim Huff, I believe, was on the defense there. Carried in offside. And that's going to be a penalty. We've got a tripping penalty coming up against South Windsor's Craig Gray. He'll go 2 minutes for tripping. That'll be at the 3:37 mark here of period number two, as Gray gets the gate for a trip. Thought they had the offside, but you could see the official on the far side clearly signaling the tripping call against Craig Gray. So Manchester will have the main advantage.
Craig Gray, 2 minutes for a tripping. Time of the penalty at 3:37.
There's the call from the public address announcer here at South Windsor Arena. So Manchester on the power play, starting up out of their own zone. Big Adam Major, their All-State defenseman, carries it in. Around the boards, Major goes down hard. He is still down, and the officials will stop play. Papagiannis, I believe, was the man that gave him the bump. It looked pretty harmless when we saw it, but obviously not, as the senior defenseman and All-Stater, number 19, Adam Major, is down on the ice and motionless. Training staff for Manchester out to attend to their star defenseman. Head coach Paul Lombardo out there as well, as we'll take another look at it. There was the hit from Papagiannis, and down went Adam Major. It looked like he took a bump right on that right shoulder. He is up now on all fours, and looks to be stretching out the leg there, but Adam Major shaken up early here in the second period. We take a look at the South Windsor Bobcat bench. And good to see that Adam Major is up, and there he is making his way to the bench under his own power, so a good sign. We hope that Adam Major comes back and can contribute again to the Manchester team in this contest. Looks to be shaking it off, getting some questions there from the medical staff, but he certainly looks to be okay, and good sign that we'll see Adam Major before this one is over. It's Ryan Short with the puck. Short fires. Rebound. Tip in by Swobodowicz. The initial shot from Ryan Short was kicked out by Ray Halley. But Adam Swobodowicz finishes it off as he tips in the rebound at the 5:12 mark of period number two. And South Windsor has surged back and taken a 2-1 lead. There is number 17, the goal scorer. I'm sure we'll get the call here in a minute from public address announcer.
Scoring the goal, scorer number 17, Adam Swobodowicz. Assisted by number 12, Ryan Short. Having the goal at 5:12, shorthanded.
So the shorthanded goal by Adam Swobodowicz with the assist to Ryan Short at the 5:12 mark gives South Windsor a 2-1 advantage. It comes with Craig Blay off 2 minutes for tripping. Swobodowicz with the shorthander and the lead for the Bobcats. Still on the power play, Manchester. South Windsor fires it down deep. Swobodowicz again applying pressure. Steals the puck, feeds center, has it tipped away. Knocked away by McKenney. Still in the corner, McKenney now will wrap it around his own net and feed it up. Back in their own zone. Nice feed up again for South Windsor, and a great check by Adam Major. So Major is back on the ice, and he lets his presence be known. Is a great check against Hayden. Hayden sent flying. Short back behind his own net. Under pressure. Checking along the boards. Short finally gets it out. And the whistle to stop play. Just outside the South Windsor blue line. A look at Dave Fisher, South Windsor head coach. This off will come just on the South Windsor side of center ice. Joe Peck, senior forward for the Manchester Indians. And there, of course, Brian LaPira, the man that got South Windsor on the board here early in the second period. They've added a Swobodowicz goal to take a 2-1 advantage. Manchester sends it up to center ice, now into the South Windsor zone. Tipped by Halley. Sent up all the way to center ice, coming out of the South Windsor box and touching up for the offside will be Derek Sendrak. So the stoppage will give us another faceoff. This one will be down in the South Windsor zone to the right-hand side of goalkeeper Ray Halley. Bill Hantos, number two, will take the face-off chore for South Windsor. And Michael McKenney will take it for Manchester. McKenney wins, but South Windsor steals as Sendrak comes back the other way. Kept in, nice job by Symes, number five for South Windsor. Lapira around the back of the net as it's sticked away by Latanzio. Latanzio struggling with it. Wants a faceoff. Lapira will finally oblige, and the referees will call the penalty, or call the stoppage, and we'll get a faceoff as number 14, Tom Latanzio, who opened up the scoring, the junior. In the first period at the 1:57 mark, it staked the Manchester Indians out to a 1-0 lead. Pair of goals here in the second period by Lapira and Swerbowitz at 1:12 and 5:12 respectively. Short takes the draw and wins it. That is Short with the puck. Back to the point to Sendrak. Sends it in. Short goes after it, tips one towards the goal. Now behind the net, he sends one center. It's stolen away by Manchester. Up the other way comes McKenney. Sends it ahead. McKenney keeps in and fires it down behind the goal. Peck goes after it in the corner. Fires it across. Fleming back behind the net for Manchester with the work. He goes back to corral it. Tries to send it behind the net. They fight for it on the far boards. Still with the puck is Fleming, looking for some help. It comes far side. They tried to feed it to Major, but could not. And we've got a whistle. So the stoppage in play. Looks like South Windsor was about to have a nice breakaway opportunity, too, just as the whistle blew. And we're gonna have some penalties. There is Tom Collins, number 15 for South Windsor, in the box. And going to the box for Manchester is Joe Peck. So a pair of coincidental minors will keep the teams at full strength. But South Windsor without the services of Tom Collins, and Manchester without the availability of Joe Peck for the next 2 minutes. Penalties coming at the 7:04 mark of period number two, and we'll wait for our public address announcer to give us the calls as to the exact nature of the two-minute minors. Dave Fisher asking for some clarification in a very gentlemanly way. As we take it back to action, that's Sendrak with the puck, Symes with the puck, number five.
Shot with the penalty at number 15, Tom Collins, 2 minutes for slashing. Manchester penalty.
So Collins goes for a slash.
And Manchester penalty at number 7, Joe Peck, 2 minutes for roughing.
And Peck goes for the rough. So Collins 2 minutes slashing, Peck 2 minutes roughing on the coincidental minors. And back the other way comes Pat Hayden. He dumps it for Swerbowitz. Swerbowitz deals, turns, still with the puck on the far boards. Nice moves by Swerbowitz. Tries to feed center, and it's tipped away. Tried to feed Hayden, who was all alone by the net. Nice effort by Swerbowitz. He has a goal in this contest. A shorthander at the 5:12 mark, which has put his team up to a 2-1 advantage. Back the other way. Number 12, Ryan Shore, is tripped down. And we'll get the call. I believe we're going to have a tripping call here. Number 12, Ryan Short, was taken down right outside the blue line, and I believe number 19, Adam Major, is going to be the man that gets the gate. Major goes to the box, and there's the tripping signal from our official. So Adam Major, 2 minutes for tripping. This one at the 8:26 mark, and the South Windsor Bobcats, with a 2-1 advantage, will go on the power play. They've got a shorthanded goal by Swerbowitz here in the second frame. To go along with Lapira's even strength goal.
2 minutes for tripping. Time for the penalty at 8:26.
And there the call. Major 2 minutes for trip at 8:26. Major gets a minor. So the Bobcats on the power play. Nice takeaway by Manchester. Back the other way, Latanzio. Latanzio with a wrister. It's blocked off the blocker by Halley. Latanzio again steals and fires in. This one deflected as South Windsor comes back the other way. That one knocked aside by Aliski. Back behind the net, Blomstrom. Kept in, nice job by South Windsor on the backhand. Ryan Short. Svobodowicz can't control. Taken away by Hayden. Hayden feeds center. Sent down by Latanzio as he clears. South Windsor still on the power play. And a major serving 2 minutes for tripping. Hayden sends it up. Dumps it back over to Svobodowicz. Takes a shot that's deflected off the leg of Scalo. Svobodowicz fights for it near side. Up the ice. Svobodowicz right up the center. Crosses the blue line. The slap, he scores! From just inside the blue line, Svobodowicz with his second goal of the contest. And now South Windsor is up by a 3-1 advantage. The power play goal from Adam Svobodowicz at the 10:09 mark of period number two. And there it was. What a blast from just inside the blue line as he beat Holly up top side and right. Goal number two, a pair right in a row. The first one at the 5:12 mark. Now this one for Svobodowicz at the 10:09 mark. And here's the announcement. Chris L. Jenkins with the low and assist is number eight. Fed Svobodowicz deep in his own zone. Adam picks up goal number two in the game. South Windsor out to a 3-1 advantage here in period number two. South Windsor feeds out. That's intercepted by Gagne. Doyle dumps in. Sendrak back behind his net. Sends out South Windsor. Kept in by Adam Major. Manchester in the zone. We're down to 4:15 to go, second period. Long lead pass intended for Hantos. Back to Corral, it is Blomstrom. Tied up in the corner, and we'll get the whistle and a face-off in the Manchester end.
Ladies and gentlemen, may your attention, please. This is the last
just under 4 minutes to go here in period number two. So it's been an all-South Windsor period. There's three goals as they have come storming back from a 1-0 deficit at the end of one to take a 3-1 advantage here on their home ice, the South Windsor Arena. This face-off in the Manchester zone. Controlled by Ryan Short, kept in by Svobodowicz. Shot on net is covered up by senior goalie Jason Aliski. There is Ryan Short. Sends one in front, intended for Hayden. A little wide. Hayden back to Corral. Dumps for Short. Short, near side. Sends it inside for Svobodowicz. Svobodowicz looking for the natural hat trick. Has it just tipped away. Manchester is having trouble clearing their own zone here. Up ahead is Gagne. He can't keep it out. Goes off the back of Tom Collins, and now finally firing it deep. is Manchester. South Windsor right back the other way on a rush. That one back checked by Manchester, sends it to neutral ice. Back into the Manchester zone. Again, taken away. Manchester steals it back. Back the other way comes Doyle. Doyle with some nice back check work. And this one will go down. Adam Major will touch it up for Manchester. Sends it ahead for McKenney. They clear it into the South Windsor zone. Papagionis back to Corralet. Ties up to his man. Tanzio with the puck. Feeds it for Adam Major. He scores! Adam Major right in front with the goal from Latanzio. And it's quickly a 3-2 game. So Adam Major with a little degree of revenge as Swobodowicz scored South Windsor's third goal with Adam Major off for a two-minute tripping call. And Adam Major has answered back and has cut the deficit now from 3-2. There is Latanzio over on the side, flips it to Major, and Major beating Holly on the right-hand side short.
Manchester goal scored by number 19, Adam Major. Assisted by number
7,
Joe Peck, and by number 14,
Carl Latanzio. For the assist to Peck and Latanzio as Major gets the goal at the 12:32 mark. And it's a 3-2 hockey game now in favor of South Windsor. South Windsor keeps the pressure on. Manchester is able to clear. Peck brings it up, along with McKenney. Peck and McKenney applying pressure. Kept in by Doyle, far side. Doyle to Peck. Peck walks in and has it sticked away. Nice job by Ray Halley. The goal by Adam Major has cut the deficit from 3-2. Latanzio and Major, the goal scorers for Manchester. A pair for Swobodowicz and Lapira here in the second period. All three goals for South Windsor.
South Windsor penalty on number 4, Chris Jenkins.
So Chris M. Jenkins, number 4, gets the South Windsor penalty. 2 minutes for hooking at 13:15. So Manchester on the power play, and they will look for the equalizer. Right now, South Windsor controls. Swobodowicz feeds up to Pat Hayden. Swobodowicz controlling, killing penalty. Now drops it back, and this is taken away by Adam Major. Major with the breakaway, far side, no! Led by Ray Halley. Great save. Otherwise, this game was all tied at 3. Big Adam Major came in all alone as he stole the back pass. Major walked in and Halley made the save, and a great one. We'll have to go back and take another look at this one as the All-State defenseman bore down, went short side on Ray Halley. There he pulled the trigger, and Halley just a piece of it to keep it outside the net. We're under a minute to go, down to 52 seconds and counting in the period. Swobodowicz goes in. And we've got a penalty as Manchester now will be penalized. Eric Blomstrand will be called for a tripping penalty as he took down Swobodowicz. This one will come at the 14:17 mark. And now each team will be down a man. Brian Short on the faceoff against Major. We're down to the 32nd mark remaining second period. There was the penalty call against Blomstrand. 2 minutes for tripping at 14-17. Nice shot taken by Pat Hayden, number 14. Short goes after it in the corner. Hayden set up in front. And Hayden bumps into Liske, and the net will come off its moorings and will get the stoppage of play. Final seconds here of period number two at the South Windsor Arena. What a game it's been, too, with South Windsor surging back here in the second period to take a 3-1 advantage, but then had a major with a goal for Manchester. He's cut it to a 3-2 game. Faceoff won by South Windsor. They keep in. Swobodowicz knocks it back in. Manchester will corral and start up ice. That's Adam Major with the puck. He feeds it down the far side as the whistle sounds. To end the second period of play, let's recap the scoring for you. South Windsor's number 11, Brian Lapierre at the 1-12 mark. Swobodowicz at the 5-12 mark, shorthanded. Swobodowicz a power play at the 10-09 mark. And Adam Major at the 12:32 mark to make it. South Windsor 3, Manchester 2, two periods of play. Stay tuned as we've got an exciting third period of hockey upcoming. We'll be back in just a moment.
Look what's happening on E.
Hey, E, what's up?
Oh, E, cool.
Very excited,
really.
E.
Going to be watching E.
Okay, here we go.
Action.
E.
E is for excitement tonight.
This is great.
Doesn't get better than this.
E.
E. Entertainment Television. It happens here.
Right here on Cox Cable.
Back here at South Winds Arena, Peter Talbot along with the Cox Television crew. South Windsor Bobcats homestanding against the Manchester Indians, and South Windsor, as you'll see there on your screen, South Windsor with a 3-2 advantage. They came up with three big goals in the second period. Adam Major with the goal for Manchester in the period. Manchester's Potenzio, the lone goal in period number one. We stand at 3-2. 15 minutes of hockey left to decide this one. Center ice faceoff, controlled by South Windsor. Slap shot just inside the blue line. Kicked away by Liske. Another slap shot from just inside the blue line. And that one will draw. Stoppage of play. Faceoff inside the Manchester zone. Robotowitz loses the faceoff to Manchester. Manchester with the pressure. Short feeds up along the left side. Knocked out again by Manchester. Manchester clears the zone, and all the way down it goes. South Windsor on the power play here to open up the third period of play. Carryover of the Blomstrand penalty. 2 minutes for tripping at 14-17 of period number two. Walking is Swobodowicz, and the shot by number 14, Pat Hayden, is just tipped wide. What a great opportunity is Swobodowicz to Hayden. Hayden with the shot from in front just had it sticked away by Liske. Great opportunity for South Windsor there. It'll be Short to take the face-off. Ryan Short, number 12, will face off against number 19, Adam Major, senior defenseman for Manchester. Control back to Swobodowicz. Manchester able to clear the zone. Sims circles in his own zone, feeds it up near boards. Hayden can't corral. Sims will try it again, and a whistle will stop play. And we've got a penalty upcoming. A at the 1:16 mark of period number three. An interference call is going to go against South Windsor's Steve Papadogionis.
South Windsor penalty on number 20, Steve Papadogionis. 2 minutes for interference. Time of the penalty at 1:16.
So the 2 minute minor for interference at 1:16 will give Manchester a whack at the power play. As soon as the penalty ends to Eric Blomstrand. Major goes back to Corral, setting it up behind his own net. In the near boards. Struggling forward on the near side. Still in the Manchester zone. South Winds are doing a nice job to keep it in. Coming away with it is short. He loses it now over to Fleming. And out comes Griffin Doyle. Griffin Doyle is checked, and that draws the applause from the crowd. Nice hit by Ryan Short, number 12, knocking Doyle off the puck. Great check. Fleming tries to move it ahead for Manchester. It's sent back in by Short. Manchester comes out on the power play. Crossing the line is McKenney. Can't control, and South Windsor sends down. Manchester again tries to set up their power play. Adam Major tripped up at the blue line. Major touches it and was not able to keep it in. He pleads his case to the linesman, but they will call an offside, as there is the senior defenseman, an all-stater from last year. For Manchester coach Paul Lombardo, that is Adam Major. Adam with a goal in the second period, the 12:32 mark. And that pulled Manchester to within 3-2. It'll be Joe Peck facing off for Manchester. He steers it ahead. Taken by Latanzio. Latanzio turns and fires. And that's covered up by Holly. Nice job. Puck did come loose, but the whistle had stopped play. Ray Holly has done a nice job in net tonight for the South Windsor Bobcats and their head coach, Dave Fisher. We mentioned during the opening that South Windsor, the defending Division II state champs, they won it last year. They, of course, have moved up to Division I this year for play. Robotowicz comes away with the puck. He's got Hayden on his right wing. Hayden now behind the net. Taken by Short. Back to Hayden. Feeds Short in front, and it's knocked away. Nice job by Liske to poke that one out of midair. Back the other way comes the Indians. Symes on defense is able to get it away. Robotowicz. Poke checked away nicely by number 4 Nick Roy for Manchester. South Windsor maintains control in the Manchester zone. Collins feeds it up ahead. Comes all the way around near side. In the corner they dig for it. It goes up over the glass. And we'll have a faceoff outside the Manchester zone. Period number 3 here at the South Windsor Arena. Peter Talbot along with the Cox Television crew. The South Windsor Bobcats have run out to a 3-2 advantage. Our director tonight, Donna Fontano, technical director Peter Cakley, Peter Chomack doing the audio tonight, Sean Ratchis on replay. Graphics being handled this period anyway by Pat Randazzo. Nice of Pat to join us tonight. Our camera operators, James Perkins, Kevin DeMello, and Bob Plunkett. South Windsor loses control as Andy Pelletier can't hang on. Manchester applying the pressure in the South Windsor zone. Setting up in front is Fleming, number 10, awaiting a pass. Blomstrand now loses control at the blue line. South Windsor kicks it ahead. Feed to Griffin. Doyle goes too far. South Windsor controls the puck. Unable to carry out. The steal and the shot by Eric Gagne. He is knocked down by Holly. Gagne again turns. Adam Major along the near boards. Pokes it away. Pokes it again to himself. He's coming in. He shoots and scores! Adam Major has tied it up at 3 for Manchester. What a nice play along the far boards by Adam Major. He notches his second goal of the contest and has staked his team out to a 3-3 tie now. There's he walked in down the right side and let one go. The blistered by Ray Holly. That at the 5:07 mark of period number 3. An unassisted goal for Adam Major. And we're all tied at 3s. And there was the call. Batted ahead with a high stick. Swobodowicz bats it down to himself but can't control. Back again comes the Manchester Indians. This is Peck with the shot. Deflected up into the glass by Holly. Holly getting a lot of pressure this period. He's getting a workout. Major has dented the nets to tie things up at 3 here. A little under 10 minutes to go in the contest. Face-off between Short and McKenney, won by Short. Near side for the Bobcats. Swobodowicz controls. Dumps it into the corner. Hayden goes to get it. Swobodowicz goes to the center. In the corner they battle. Ryan Short sends it out. Shot from the point is deflected away by Liske. And Manchester able to clear the zone. Nice poke check against Swobodowicz. And South Windsor again is back to corral. Joe Peck walks in, shoots and scores! Joe Peck with the score as he walked in on the left side. And Manchester is now up by a count of 4-3. McKenney worked in the corner, got the puck back as here we see the replay. There Peck walks in and on the near side put it right through the pads of Holly. And Manchester has regained the lead at 4-3. Patanzio opened up the scoring for Manchester in the first period at the 1:57 mark, and Manchester led at the end of 1-1-0. South Windsor came back with 3 straight goals from Lopera and 2 from Swobodowicz to take a 3-1 lead. Adam Major cut it to 3-2 before period number 2 ended. Adam Major tied it at 3 here, and Peck has now staked the Indians out to a 4-3 lead. Whistle on the icing. We'll move it all the way down as Tom Collins touches up for the icing call. What a pair of quick goals here. Just a minute and 6 seconds after Adam Major's goal, Joe Peck tickles the net. In the Manchester end. Pantos, number 2, fighting for it along the near boards. Now takes it. Sends it out in front. Collins unable to hang on. Back the other way comes Manchester. That one deflected away by Holly as a long shot was just tipped away. 2-on-1 opportunity again for the Indians. Windsor starts up. in center ice. Pass across the near boards. It's tipped away. Now South Windsor controls in the zone, and Manchester recaptures behind their own net. Feeding up along the far boards. Griffin Doyle able to take it out, and we're going to have a whistle and a penalty. Michael Griffin Doyle, number two, is going to get a two-minute penalty. So his team with a 4-3 advantage, and now South Windsor will have a power play opportunity as Griffin Doyle will get the gate at the 7:36 mark of period number three. Referee gets him for an elbowing call. Again at the 7:36 mark of period number three. So South Windsor will be back on the power play. A great opportunity for the Bobcats here. They have short Swobodowicz in Hayden. Well, they didn't call Griffin Doyle, but trust me, it is Michael Griffin Doyle with the penalty.
Correction level is Mike Stoll.
In the near end, Symes unable to keep it in. Short goes back for it, sends it across the boards. Near side at Symes, heads up for Hayden. Swobodowicz now short. Short gets it back again. Feeds in the center. Into the corner they go. And Manchester able to clear the zone. All the way down and forces Holly to make a save on it. Papadogiannis corrals, now Swobodowicz. Near side, and his shot is a goal! Swobodowicz again, just inside the blue line. And take off your hat for Adam Swobodowicz. That's his third of the game, and we are all tied at four. Again, just inside the blue line, it went off the right glove side of Liske and deflected into the net. Adam Swobodowicz with his third goal of the game, and we're all tied at four. There, a nice look at number 17 with the hat trick. Swobodowicz, back-to-back goals in the second period at the 5-12 mark and the 8:26 mark, and make that the 10:09 mark. And now scoring here with an assist from Ryan Short. Period number 4 at the 8:23 mark. All tied at fours. Craig Guay with a shot that goes up high. Back behind the net as you take a look at Jason Liske, senior goaltender for Manchester. What a great hockey game this has been. All tied up at fours. What a great action. Some nice goaltending, some great saves, some good goals as well. Just outside the Manchester zone. Faceoff controlled by South Windsor, but they lose it. Kicked back in by Matt Williams, number 24. Centering, but knocked away by Fleming. South Windsor fires back in. Adam Major back for the puck behind his own net. Takes a hit and is dumped. And Adam Major is still down after taking that low hip check from Andy Pelletier. Number 22, innocently Adam Major was set up behind his own net, waiting for some help. He dumped it off and Pelletier came in and gave him a hip check, and Adam Major went straight down. He is now back up. Still bent over, as there you see him in your screen, number 19. Senior defenseman for Coach Paul Lombardo. He's pleading his case right now to the officials. Looking for maybe a charging call. He will stay in the game. Santos will take the draw for South Windsor. He faces off against his counterpart, number two, Michael Griffin Doyle for Manchester. Hantos wins the draw and got off a quick wrister that sailed over the top of the net. Hantos right back for it, looking for some help. walks in, has it deflected away. Into the near corner they go. Sent out right towards the goal. Manchester clears it down. Blomstrand sends it all the way back. Pintos starts up, crosses into Manchester territory. Stick handling, looking for some help. Now they lose control. Back the other way comes Doyle. Slap shot on net, forces Holly to make a save. All tied at four here at South Windsor Arena. Lapira starts up the left side. Number 11 walks in, loses control. Nice defensive stop by Adam Major. And back the other way comes McKenney. McKenney walking in, shoot, no! Nice save by Ray Holly. Love save by Holly as Michael McKenney walked in. McKenney assisted on the opening goal of the contest. Goal by Tom Latanzio. And he had himself a great opportunity there. He also came up with the assist on the Joe Peck goal here in this period at 6:13. So a pair of assists for McKenney, and he nearly had himself a tiebreaker there. McKenney will take the faceoff against Ryan Short. Swerbodowicz wins it and has himself a little rush. Adam Major gives him a bump in the Manchester zone. And this one will be coming back for a multiple line pass. There is Swerbodowicz, the gentleman with the hat trick tonight. His third of three has tied things at four. Take the draw against Short. Short wins it and advances it forward. Sent across for Hayden. He can't control. Collins loses it. Back the other way. McKenney another chance. Feeds. Centering pass. No. Joe Peck can't put it in. Nice feed from McKenney to Peck, and they can't click. Nice job by Holly again to redirect that one. Back the other way, Swerbodowicz tries to feed Short. As we go end-to-end now with Peck sending one in on net. That's stick-checked away by Holly. Windsor comes out with it. Swerbodowicz trying for number four, and that seems to be his spot. Just inside the blue line, he lets another one rip. Jason Liske is able to corral that one. The glove in between the pads. Keep the score tied up at fours. End-to-end action now between these two teams. Greg Gway on the draw against Doyle. Doyle controls. Manchester is able to clear. Two-on-one break. Doyle with the shot. It's corralled by Holly. Michael Griffin Doyle from just inside the blue line in a two-on-one break. Let's one crank that Holly controls. Ray Holly has made some great saves here in the third period to keep this game tied at two. A breakaway by McKenney. And now a two-on-one opportunity for Peck. Gway against Doyle for the faceoff. Manchester keeps it in momentarily. South Windsor now. Centering pass soars wide. Kept in by Papadogiannis. Now another opportunity for Manchester. That is number 18, Gagne, with the attempt, and Holly turns him away. And he gets congratulated by Craig Gway. And now number four also going over there. That's Chris M. Jenkins to pat him as Short goes by and taps him on the pads. There's Hayden. Holly has just done a great job as he's turned Manchester away three straight times now on great opportunities, and the score remains tied at four. Ryan Short will take the faceoff for South Windsor against McKenney. Goes back to Symes. Symes wraps it around to his defense mate. Up it goes to Short. Short looks for Swobodowicz. Swobodowicz brings it in. Back the other way comes Blomstrand. He sends it out. The feed for Latanzial. South Windsor now is Hayden. Far boards. That is Short, number 12. Feeding Symes. Symes, the shot deflected. Back into neutral ice. The race. McKenney gets there first, tries to feed Peck, but it's batted away. Another scoring chance for Manchester. Back the other way, Hayden and Swobodowicz try to hook up on a two-on-one, and that one just sails out of the reach of Adam Swobodowicz. Whistle stops play. The puck went into the net there, but the whistle had stopped play. Hayden is down. Pat Hayden, the winger, for Coach Dave Fisher of South Windsor. There's a couple of words for one of your Manchester players. Don't think he was wishing them happy holidays. Swobodowicz will stay on the ice along with Short. Short will take the draw. Collins in on defense.
Manchester penalty on number 19, Adam Major. 2 minutes for slashing.
So the penalty against Adam Major at the 12:37 mark as he gets 2 minutes for slashing against Hayden. In South Windsor with a great opportunity as Hayden are up. Short walked in, but could not pull the trigger. South Windsor with a big power play opportunity here late in the third period of a game tied at four. From his knees, the wraparound attempt by Lapira. Short took a poke at that puck, and he gets a talking to from Alex Scola. But the penalty by Adam Major, 2 minutes for slashing at 12:37, has given South Windsor a great power play opportunity here late in the contest. Flip to center ice. Swobodowicz sends it in. Short follows. And another whistle. Saved by Liske. Controlled the puck. South Windsor on the power play. Closing minutes of the third period here at the South Windsor Arena. Papadogiannis, number 20, into the contest. Ryan Short, number 12, will take the faceoff. Big faceoff it is, too. Controlled by South Windsor. Hantos sends it down around the boards. Far corner. Hantos set up in front. Tip attempt by Lapira. No good. Hantos still in front. Goes out to the far corners. Now to the blue line. The shot taken. Knocked down by the crowd in front. And Manchester just able to clear the zone. South Windsor regroups and sends it back in. We're down under a minute to play in the contest. Time running out on the South Windsor opportunity. Tip attempt in front. Tapped away by Liske. Out to the point it goes, and Peck has it. And Peck will come in alone. Peck scores, and Manchester has taken the lead with 29 seconds remaining. shot and beat Ray Holly on the near side. South Windsor was unable to keep it in at the point, and there is the result as Peck puts it in under the sliding effort of Ray Holly, and with just 29 seconds remaining, the Manchester Indians have taken a 5-4 lead. What a period of hockey, is trailing by a score of 3-2. Manchester came out with a pair of goals by Major and Peck to take a 4-3 lead once again. Swobodowicz finished off his hat trick and tied things at 4. And now it's Joe Peck with the assist to McKenney at 14:31, and Manchester is on top by a 5-4 score. South Windsor calls timeout with just a half minute to go. They'll talk things over. We'll take a break along with them and be back for the final 30 seconds in just a moment.
Searching for Fox movies? Stick around. Fox Sports. Fox shows.
Unbelievable.
Searching for the power of Fox? You'll find it on FX. Fox Gone Cable.
Get today's hottest entertainment on FX and Cox Cable.
Back here at the South Windsor Arena, following the South Windsor timeout, the Bobcats have regrouped and will send out the troops for the final 29 seconds of the contest. The Manchester goal by Joe Peck with the assist to McKenney has given the Indians a 5-4 advantage with just 29 ticks remaining. Face off at center ice is Gray. Wins it back for South Windsor. It goes all the way back to the South Windsor red line. South Windsor obviously will look to try to pull their goalie, Ray Holly. They're unable to come out with it. Now they get it up. It's intercepted by Manchester. Manchester doing a nice job of keeping it in as Peck actually got a shot away there. South Windsor running out of time. Now they come up. They're at center ice and a big check. And that will do it. The final 29 seconds have tipped off, and Manchester is able to preserve the 5-4 victory. What a great effort by Manchester as they stormed back to win this contest 5-4. Manchester opened up the scoring in the first period as Tom Latanzio, with an assist from McKenney, scored at the 1:57 mark. Manchester took a 1-0 lead into the first period locker room. In the second period, the Bobcats came out with a vengeance. Brian Lapira unassisted at the 1:12 mark. Then Adam Swobodowicz, the first of three, a shorthanded goal with the assist to Ryan Short at 5:12. Swobodowicz on the power play in the second period at 10:09, the assist to Chris L. Jenkins. And Adam Major finished out the second period scoring, assist to Peck and Latanzio at the 12:32 mark. It was Adam Major, Joe Peck, Swobodowicz, and Peck scoring here in period number three in our final of 5-4, Manchester over South Windsor. Good night from South Windsor Arena.